Have you ever noticed that some incredibly simple things cost absolutely crazy money, and there's no logical explanation for the price at all? Well, today, I'm going to show you how you can save from 600 euros to 5,000 euros using nothing more than an anemometer, a plastic plate, a piece of drain pipe, and a few other everyday items you probably already have at home. In this video, you'll learn how to build a useful device with your own hands, why you need it, how it helps you save money, and, the most exciting part, how you can actually make great money with it, both by building the device and by offering services using it. Don't skip ahead. Today I'm revealing all the secrets. First, we need to prepare the drain pipe. Its length should be no more than 25 centimeters, otherwise the measurement error will increase dramatically, and calculating the K factor will become almost impossible. And the K factor is crucial. It shows how accurately your device converts the airflow speed into a readable value. The more precise the dimensions, the more stable and reliable your measurements will be. Anemometers come in different designs and with different propeller diameters, so we choose the drain pipe specifically to match the diameter of the propeller. This ensures a proper airflow pattern inside the pipe, and as a result, a correct K factor. Next, we take the connecting part of the pipe, measure it, and transfer these dimensions onto the bottom of a deep plastic plate. To make everything as precise as possible, I use a caliper, and then, with the help of a compass, I transfer the measurements and draw a perfect circle right in the center of the plate. Right after cutting the opening, make sure to carefully remove all the plastic shavings and debris. This is extremely important to prevent the anemometer from malfunctioning and to avoid incorrect readings caused by debris getting onto the fan blades, or even worse, wrapping around the motor shaft. Now let's move on to making the mount. We take measurements from the entire device body and transfer them onto the drain pipe. This is exactly where our sensor will be installed. Every anemometer may have a slightly different mounting system, but the idea is always the same. We need to attach it as tightly and as securely as possible so it doesn't wobble or vibrate, since that also affects accuracy. The anemometer is one of the oldest measuring instruments in history. The very first working model was invented by Leon Battista Alberti back in 1450. Just imagine, nearly six centuries have passed. Eras changed, technologies evolved, computers and smartphones appeared, yet the anemometer is still with us. And the most fascinating part? Its operating principle has remained almost unchanged. Just like centuries ago, the device catches the airflow, turns it into motion, and we convert that motion into precise numbers. A true piece of engineering brilliance that has survived the ages.
It's essential to use a seal, installed along the edge of the plate and inside the drain pipe. It prevents any air leaks that may occur due to an imperfect connection. Seals come in various types: silicone, rubber, and other materials. It's recommended to choose one that is soft but not too firm, so it can closely follow the surface's irregularities. The softer the seal, the tighter you can press the plate against the wall, minimizing air losses. Hard or overly stiff seals, on the other hand, can cause leaks and reduce measurement accuracy. While the device isn't finished yet, I want to spark a bit of curiosity. What exactly are we making? Almost every home with natural ventilation, or even a heat recovery system, requires precise mathematical tuning. poorly adjusted ventilation can seriously affect your health. Excessive positive or negative pressure forms, drafts appear. You may experience coughing and other problems. It's important to understand, one anemometer is not enough to measure airflow accurately. Airflow is always uneven, stronger on one side, weaker on the other, depending on the angle and distance from the vent. This is why we have the air bolometer, a device used to measure the volumetric airflow at the outlet of vents, diffusers, and other air distribution points. The bolometer is a cone-shaped attachment that captures the entire airflow and allows you to measure the average air velocity to calculate the flow. It's much more precise and convenient than a regular anemometer, especially in areas with uneven airflow. But there's a problem. The cheapest bolometer costs around 600 euros, and some models go up to 5 to 6,000 euros. Far too expensive and impractical for home use. With our device, you can do the same job. Moreover, it can be upgraded by adding a pressure sensor, which measures airflow speed and volume even more accurately. But it's not as simple as it seems. Inside the plate and pipe, turbulent airflow forms, causing the air to accelerate and giving incorrect readings. Professional instruments use special internal vanes to stabilize the flow and evenly direct it onto the measuring blades. We'll make them ourselves, out of cardboard. To minimize the effects of static electricity, we'll cover the vanes with aluminum foil. Moving air can electrify dust particles, which settle on the blades or motor shaft, creating resistance and distorting readings. Aluminum, thanks to its conductivity, dissipates static charge, ensuring precise and stable measurements. The finished airflow stabilizer is installed inside the plate and securely fixed around the edges with hot glue. Thanks to this homemade device, I was able not only to solve the problem in my own home and save around 1,000 euros compared to even the cheapest bolometer, but also earn a few hundred euros by helping neighbors set up their home systems. Our device is just as effective as a commercial one. As I mentioned earlier, you can install up to 4 plugs on the plate, which connect to a manometer, allowing even more precise measurements. Remember, your health depends on proper ventilation system setup. Don't neglect it. Check that everything is working correctly in your home. Stay healthy, and see you in the next video.